Take it to the riverside. Ik heb die mixtape van Schippers bij. Camarero doet er nog maar tissen bij. Ik kan niet meer zitten, like die Sarah speelt een riff. What's up everybody, it's the white boy from the yard and I'm back at it again with another video. Today I'm going to talk about my 12-week Austrian cycle, the length, the dosages.
As a disclaimer, I'm not a doctor, I don't have any form of medical degrees, I don't pretend to be a doctor, don't listen to what I say, this is all my personal opinion on how I see things and what I would do to my body. Always see a doctor before using any form of supplements, it's for research only and not for human consumption.
Austrian, aka MK2866, aka Enbosarm. So Austrian is actually designed to prevent the muscle wasting disease, so it's extremely powerful, helping you maintain muscle while in a calorie deficit. Austrian, aka Enbosarm, is currently the most studied SARM out there, being one of the few that have actually human clinical studies, but alongside as well as thousands others of bodybuilders that are using it for personal research like me. Now, what Austrian does, it binds to the androgen receptors, as well as any other SARM actually. SARMs target the androgen receptors without interfering with any other processes. It mimics the effect of testosterone while only targeting the androgen receptors, so it doesn't convert into estrogen at all, which also means not having any side effects like cycles as testosterone. So no hair loss, no prostate enlargement, no gyno. I mean, there have been people complaining about the fact that they got gyno from SARMs. Okay, well, just let me clarify this, okay? This is not because of the Austrian itself. It's your natural testosterone that is not being used because it's getting overlapped by something that acts like testosterone. Most likely in higher dosages, longer periods of time, and in my opinion, different compounds like Rad 140. It probably won't happen, guys, but there seems to be a really small chance that you could get any of these side effects from even Austrian. Because if you Google it, you can see that some guys complain about the fact that they got gyno from Austrian. But what it does is specifically targets the bone and muscle tissues. So I really think there's just a 10% chance you will get any of these side effects from using a low dosage of Austrian. But again, everybody's body is different. Austrian is one of the, if not the most safe compound to use for men and women compared to other performance enhancing drugs. But still, I don't advise to use this. It's all for studies and for studies only, okay? So my personal study was the Austrian cycle from 12 weeks. I was cutting down and I wanted to lose the excess fat I've gained from my bulking. I started by doing one capsule each day, which was 10 milligrams. The half-life is 24 hours, so I took it once a day, first thing in the morning, before even consuming my breakfast, along with all the vitamin pills I take and everything. I started noticing the effects like a little later than I did for my Ligandrol cycle. In my Ligandrol cycle, I felt the effects on day 4, and with Austrian, it took a little bit longer. It was at day 6 that I could really feel the energy, the pump, and the drive in the gym, and actually the overall hardness started coming up at day 6 and or 7 or something. So like I said, I started noticing the effects and what it would do to my body. And then every week that went by, I didn't even lose any strength while in a calorie deficit. That actually seemed to increase my strength for a little bit. And that's just amazing since most people lose strength while cutting down. So I was 4 weeks into my cut and I dropped over 17 pounds, lost a lot of body fat and did not lose any muscle. Nothing. Zero. And at this point, you know, I wanted to crank it up. So I took 20 milligrams each day. That's 2 capsules, also first thing in the morning. And so far on, I run it like this for 12 weeks. Since I've seen my body just reacted good on the 20 milligrams, I didn't want to get any higher, I didn't want to get any lower, so 20 milligrams was kind of the sweet spot for me. But now what? This happened in week 12. I mean, the gains and the cuts were great. I lost 22 pounds and didn't lose any muscle, but I was just feeling tired. I think my body was done with supplementing this and maybe my natural testosterone got suppressed like a little bit. Strength gain stopped at probably like week 8. But after that, I didn't lose any strength at all, so that's good. 2 weeks after the cycle, I kept my gains, I felt good, I kept the lean mass out of it. But sure, some weeks after that, you will lose the hardness in the muscles, but that's with any PED. But still, overall, it was a great cycle, a great experience, and I really hope this information helped bodybuilding chemistry and human evolution. So that was it for today's video, guys. Thanks a whole lot for watching again. If you want more reviews, more diet, more nutrition plans, workout videos, whatsoever, don't be afraid to ask. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell so you get noticed whenever new videos come online. Go to Anabolic TV by Enhanced Athlete and subscribe there as well. More bodybuilding chemistry videos are coming up, so stay tuned. I'm thinking about shooting the road to my first bodybuilding competition with SARMs only. Go to my Instagram and drop a follow at whiteboyfromtheyard. Do the same thing on my Facebook, which is that whiteboyfromtheyard. Let's grow together. Stop wasting time researching things on the internet while things are just getting laid out for you like that. It's that wiper from the yard. I'm out.